Okay, so coming up, we are going to take a look at a new way that you can harness the power of cloud authentication while still keeping your passwords on-premises using Azure Active Directory pass-through authentication and seamless single sign-on capabilities. We're going to show you how you can securely use Azure Active Directory to validate passwords against on-premises Active Directory without the need for an expensive on-premises infrastructure, and how you can automatically sign in your users when they are at work. So please join me with a nice round of applause for Alex Simons, Director of Azure Active Directory Product Manager.
Thanks, Simon.
No worries. So thank you for taking us through a little bit of password authentication here. What is the idea of password authentication, and why would people want Azure Active Directory?
Yeah, well, that's a great question, Simon. So look, today we're announcing the general availability of pass-through authentication. It's a great new way to take the power of Azure Active Directory and use it for all the things that people do. Like they get to cloud apps and they manage passwords and usernames, they take care of group assignments, they worry about how their users can get seamless sign-on, and they do things like conditional access. But you can now do all of that without having to have any kind of expensive on-premise infrastructure while still keeping your passwords securely on-premise.
Well, that sounds like a really great idea, but why does it actually matter to be able to do this?
Well, I mean, the thing you got to keep in mind is that your identity control plane is a really important capability, right? You want to be able to reach out to the cloud and control all of these different cloud apps and devices, right? And so pass-through authentication gives you a really easy way to do that without having to run a giant like ADFS server farm or anything like that on premise.
How have people done this in the past? What's been the traditional way that people have actually had their configuration in place?
Yeah, well, so traditionally, Simon, there have been three different options people have used, right? So the first thing they've done is they've just synced their usernames up into the cloud, right? And then they've had a different username, a different password on-premise and one in the cloud. So you could use the same username, but you didn't have the same passwords. Then some people use our password hash sync. That takes a hash of your password, copies it up to the cloud, and then you can sign in with the same username and password in both. And this is pretty popular, particularly with smaller businesses, right, where they just want something simple and fast. Now, if you're a big enterprise, you probably use Active Directory Federation services. Now, this has the advantage that when someone goes to authenticate with Azure AD, their passwords are back on-premise, and you get to use all of the advantages of things like smart cards and third-party MFA providers that ADFS has traditionally integrated with that weren't available in the cloud.
When we start thinking about password authentication, what's actually the difference there, and how have we put password authentication into practice?
Well, so the way this works, Simon, is you install a small connector on-premise. That connector can sit on the AD Connect server, it can sit on your AD server. In fact, we recommend you put it in a bunch of different places. Now, when a user goes to authenticate, they put their username and password in, right, in the same form in Azure AD as normal, and that we take it and then we encrypt it and put it onto a queue. And so up in that queue in the cloud, it's sitting there waiting for the agent to come check. So the agent calls out and brings down that encrypted username and password.
And that, I presume, is actually an outbound configuration, so over HTTPS and probably port 443 to make it secure.
Yeah, that's right. It's a nice thing because there's no inbound traffic into your firewall. It's all outbound, so that's a good security practice. Right? And then the agent takes the private key that it knows, it cracks the username and password, plays it against your AD on-premise, figures out what the results are, and then passes those back up to Azure AD in the cloud. Right, and then Azure AD can do all the things it normally does. For instance, you know, it can let the user know that they need to, that they're approved, or it can go and force them to do a multi-factor authentication. But you know, all of the value that you get from Azure Active Directory, conditional access, and identity protection now are available to you using this technique.
So it sounds like it's actually a far simpler mechanism to put in place than being able to have to deploy, say, Active Directory Federation services.
Yeah, it's much, much simpler to get up and running than it is to run a bunch of ADFS servers. I tell you what, should we take a look at a demo?
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay, so if we can switch over to this machine here. So look, this looks just like your normal, in fact, if you're looking at the new login experience for Azure AD, right? So it looks just like a normal one, but this is using pass-through authentication. So I'm Abby Spencer at Woodgrove. I go ahead, I click next. Oh, hey, that looks really standard, right? I'm gonna put in my password, and there. I'm logged in. right? Like, it's just like your normal thing. But what happened here is it went all the way back to my on-premise Active Directory, validated my username and password, but it then also adheres to all of the rules that my on-premise directory have, like when I have to change my passwords, what hours I can log in. All of those things that maybe you've invested in over time in your on-premise AD can now be used from the cloud without having to have an ADFS server.
So what was really happening behind the scenes there?
Well, so in that one, right, what happened was the user went out, well, it was just like we talked about before, right? So the agent went out to the cloud, picked up the encrypted username and password, brought it back on premise, played it against AD, got back the success criteria, and let me log in. Now, I don't have MFA turned on, so that's okay, right?
Yeah.
Now, let's go ahead and take a look at the seamless SSO, right? Because that's the other thing that we're announcing is GA. So if we go over, I'm going to switch to a different machine. So here, you can see, let me show you. I'm logged in on this domain joined machine. Right, so okay. The previous one wasn't domain joined. This one is. I'm logged in as Abby here. And then I'm going to bring up, and just to prove it works, I'm going to do this in Chrome, too. Right, so here I am in a Chrome browser. I'm just going to go to the My Apps panel. Now, you have to pay attention. This little flash you just saw there,
that was quick.
That's Azure AD asking for a Kerberos token from Windows. Mm-hmm. Windows client gets the Kerberos token, passes it to Azure AD, and boom, I'm signed in. No username and password at all.
How does that actually work behind the scenes? What are we doing with that Kerberos authentication?
Yeah, so this one's particularly cool, right? So what's happening in the Kerberos authentication is when we run Azure AD Connect, it creates a machine account in my on-premise directory, right, that represents Azure AD in the cloud. Mm-hmm. So now when I go to log into Azure AD, Azure AD asks my PC, hey, give me a Kerb ticket. Right, and since the PC has visibility of the Active Directory, it can get a Kerb ticket, pass it to Azure AD. Azure AD trusts the on-premise directory, cracks the token, just like it was an app almost, right?
Yeah.
Cracks open that token, sees the username, and goes ahead and logs me on into the cloud. Right, now that's really cool because I get all the value of my on-premise AD and Kerb tickets all done up in the cloud, really easy. And then that Kerb ticket is good for 12 hours. Right, so even if I take my laptop and go home, right, I still get that same experience overnight. And then the worst case, let's say the Kerb ticket expired, right? Then all I'd have to do is log in again like we were seeing earlier with password authentication. So it really is a really nice simplification. And seamless SSO like this works with all of our login technologies. It's not just a thing for password authentication. You could use it with password sync, and you can use it with all of our other authentication technologies as well.
That's really cool, and it is just that one agent that's deployed on-premises or maybe a couple of agents in order to be able to provide a higher availability scenario.
Yeah, that's right, and those little agents, wherever you put them, right, they're automatically updating and we load balance across them, right? So it's a really great way to make sure you have a high availability, low maintenance deployment of Azure Active Directory.
So can you show us how you actually would configure that inside of Azure Active Directory Connect?
Yeah, let's take a look. So super easy to do, right? So those of you who have set up Azure AD before have used Azure AD Connect probably, right? So we've just added in some new options. So when you go into the wizard, you want to make sure you click on the customize section. And then you can see here, we've now added this option for pass-through authentication, and I want to enable single sign-on, right? And that's it. That's the only difference. Now, you know, I enter my passwords and stuff like that. Other things happen. But that's all you got to do to get it set up using AD Connect. And then what we're going to do is go use our group policy editor, right? So in group policy, I'm going to go ahead and now there's a trick happening under the covers here, right?
Okay.
So Azure AD is asking my PC to give us a Kerb token. Mm-hmm. And the PC doesn't want to do that unless it thinks that Azure AD is in the intranet zone.
Yeah.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come into my policies. And under my Windows components and in Internet Explorer, I'm going to change my site zones a little bit, right? So let's go ahead. We're going to take a look at the change I've made here. I've moved the two key Azure AD endpoints mm-hmm. from being on the internet into the intranet zone by setting this value to 1, right? And so now the browser, the PC and the browser will do what Azure AD wants. It'll give them a curb. It'll give us a curb token mm-hmm. so that we can do that validation because, you know, you've kind of tricked the PC into what zone you're in. Right, but that's all you got to do. You push this out using group policy, and hey, you're all set.
So that's actually all there is to it, just a couple of Azure Active Directory settings inside of Azure AD Connect and a couple of settings inside of group policy, and then that's going to work for all of your, I guess, Windows 10 machines, but Windows 7 and Windows 8 machines as well.
Yeah, it even works for a Mac.
Wow, okay. Yeah. And what about other browsers?
Yeah, so in fact, I was showing you, it works in Chrome, right? Works in Internet Explorer. It'll be working in Edge really soon. So all of these things, right? It's just, we're just using the same standards that Windows has always had. So you can use it back to a lot of old versions. Super nice. And it's just using the power of Kerberos.
When can folks actually get hold of Azure Active Directory Connect with all of these capabilities in there, and whereabouts can they learn more about what they need to do?
Well, the easiest thing to do is to go into the portal. In fact, why don't I show you in the portal, right, where you can get a hold of all this stuff. So I'm here back in my original thing. I'm going to go to the Azure portal, and I'm going to show you a couple of cool things. First, you can, when you've got your agents on premise, you can monitor them here from your console, right? So let's go ahead and look at Azure AD Connect. And you can see here, I've got federation turned off, obviously. Yeah. I've got seamless single sign-on turned on, and then I've got pass-through authentication enabled. And then when I click into this, I can see all of the connectors I have. I can see where they are, what IP address they're coming from, and what their status is. So if I'm having trouble with a connector, I can tell which one might be not working correctly. But like I was saying, this is really nice because you're monitoring these all from the cloud. They all get updated automatically from the cloud. There's no extra overhead for you to take on to run this. And then this is the same place where you can come up here, and if you want to download additional connectors, so let's say you want to install them on additional ADDSs, or some other set of servers for your HA, you just get all of this right here, right? So essentially, you got two things. You want to get Azure AD Connect, right? You want to run the group policy tool. Those are the two. And then if you want to do high availability, just come here and get the MSI.
That's really cool. And obviously, you kind of mentioned it really quickly there, but your on-premises controls are being enforced as well. So if you've got password lockout policies and those kind of things, those are actually still going to be used. And I guess you're also going to get some additional protections maybe from Azure Active Directory?
Yeah, it's almost like the best of both worlds, right? So I'm going to get all of the value I've built up in AD over time, like you were saying, lockout policies and times I can log in and password policies, things like that. But I'm also going to get the value of Azure AD in the cloud. So for instance, I'm going to get DDoS protection, mm-hmm. right? I don't have to worry about how do I protect my ADFS servers anymore. I'm going to get lockout protection from the cloud. I'm going to get all of the things that we do with Azure Identity Protection that protect certain IP addresses and make sure that you don't get hit by the hackers. All that value, you now could essentially think of the Microsoft Cloud protecting your on-premise AD while allowing people to seamlessly authenticate.
That's fantastic. And all of that authentication still happening on-premises, like a lot of people want for their regulatory requirements.
That's right. Like if you have regulatory requirements or a really, really stiff CISO, yep. right, now you can meet all those requirements.
That's fantastic. Alex, thank you very much for joining us on the Microsoft Mechanics Live stage. Did you guys like that? You think it was useful? Seems like maybe this might be a little bit of a hit product here. And obviously the big news is that this has all gone to general availability this week.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, so you can get hold of it today. You can use it in production. Absolutely fantastic. Thank you very much for joining us on the Mechanics stage. And thank you all for watching and keep watching Microsoft Mechanics on the website as often as you can do so that you can keep up with the latest in updates. And we'll see you the next time. Thank you very much.